Worshipful Mayor, County Borough of Maida Gwynedd, Counter Brian Clemens, Madam Mayoress. The Worshipful Mayor of Stratford upon Avon, Councillor Sheila Price, near Consort. The Worshipful Mayor of Aberdeen, Councillor Tony O'Donovan and Dio, Mayoress. Deputy Mayor and Deputy Mayoress, Councillor David Wiltshire. Right Honourable Lewis Smith, MP, and Mrs. Smith, our President John Hopkins and Mrs. Hopkins, our Conductor Emeritus John Tunley and Mrs. Tunley, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, may I, on behalf of the Bowman Mayor Choir, extend to you a very, very warm welcome here this evening to Aberdeen Leisure Centre for this, our 53rd annual concert. It is obviously a very important occasion. We have many concerts, and every concert is for us very important. But no concert at home or abroad can present the challenge that our own annual concert does. It is for us a very important occasion. We feel that it sets our adrenaline going, we want to do well, and obviously the gentlemen behind me have got their adrenaline flowing, and they are champing at the bit and want to get started, and I won't delay them any longer than I can. All it requires me to do is to introduce the principals of tonight's concert, which I now do. They need very little in the way of an introduction, but it is my pleasure and my privilege to ask you to welcome the Beaufort Male Choir. Mention the age of a lady, nor even do you insinuate or reflect on the age of a lady. Well, I've got to go against that this evening, because in my next introduction to the next lady I'm going to introduce, I have to say that there are not many choristers on this stage tonight, and not very many of you in the audience, that can remember a concert with the Bowman Male Choir in this hall when she wasn't one of the principal participants. The reason for that is, it is our accompanist Margaret Davis. This is her 33rd consecutive annual concert. It shows obviously that not only has she got virtuosity with a play in which he's got dedication and loyalty to the choir. Thank you, Margaret, very much indeed. Before I introduce the next of our principals, I have to say that we are starting off, the choir that is, starting off with a selection of three pieces, and I need to mention what they are and why they've been put into the programme, because I think everyone knows that Verdi is one of the world's greatest composers, and not too many concert programs with male choirs or other choirs do not have a Verdi piece in it. But tonight, our musical director very specifically has put three of Verdi's pieces. The reason being that, of course, Verdi, Giuseppe Verdi, was born in 1813 and died in 1901. So this is the 100th year of the death of Verdi, and our musical director thought it would be appropriate to include three pieces to honour and pay as a tribute to him. The first of the pieces that we're going to sing is Coro de Masmundieri, which is the Brigand's Chorus. And the when I said the gentlemen of the Bowman Male Choir, they suddenly are going to change into brigands. And anybody looking at them will know that they are a casting director's dream. And then that's going to be followed by something, a piece of music that you all have grown up knowing, and that is the Anvil Chorus from Il Trovatore. And then, of course, we go on to the third of Verdi pieces, which is something you all love, something that's included in so many male choir repertoires, and that is the Chorus of the Hebrew Slaves, Var Pensiero. Now it's my privilege to introduce someone who is going to make the concert go with a flow. He's the very talented, he's the very experienced, hard taskmaster, but he's our conductor, he's our musical director. He's our maestro. Will you please give a very warm welcome to Geraint Davis?
The Roman Gypsy, 'tis a
gentlemen, before I hand over to the rest of the program to our very capable musical director, I have one more introduction to make, and that, of course, is our guest artist this evening. 3 years ago, for our 50th celebratory annual concert, we decided, because in previous years we had an array of international artists, we decided that it was an opportunity to give an introduction to Emmerich to two young artists from the Principality, a young soprano from Trinidad and a mezzo soprano from Tonnerre. Those of you that were in the audience that evening know that we were enthralled by them, and we knew that their future musically was secure. We also knew that in the course of time we would be having them back to sing to you in Emmerich. And one of them this evening is coming back to sing to you. We knew then that her career was going to take off. And those of you that watched the Cardiff Singer of the World competition in Cardiff this year will have seen her on television. She did great credit to herself and great credit to Wales. She is a lovely lady, a lovely singer. Please will you give a very warm welcome to our artist this evening, our guest artist, who will start her program with the lovely Schubert Ave Maria and then Michael Pollack's arrangement of Begelia and Gwenyn Gwyn. Would you give a very warm Emmerich welcome to Joanne Thomas?
Thank you. we sing a lovely little spiritual Angels Watching Over Me, which particularly features our very fine Saturday sanctuary here. But first of all, we'd like to sing another hymn tune, far less familiar, I think, hymn tune Adwelva.
Thank you.
evening. No, I mean that in the nicest way. Especially I know from Evan Vale and Caldecott and I'm sure other choirs as well. And those people, I'm sure, are very aware of the Welsh male choir repertoire. Holds a very special place for certain, I can call them old war horses, pieces that were composed in the early years of the last century, and which have a very special place in the repertoire of male choirs. And I think none more so than this, with which we're going to end the first half. It is one of those epic pieces which I think male choirs particularly love singing. It's a setting by Welsh composer Daniel Clothero of Longfellow's poem telling of the exploits of King Olaf of Norway. The poem is Nidaros. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we start the second half, I have a duty to perform, a very pleasant duty, I may say, because our organization, this choir, like most other organizations, tend to have a fluid membership. Choristers come and choristers go. They leave for various reasons, some because of age, infirmity, illness, whatever, a multitude of reasons. But in order that we can maintain our standard, it is imperative that we have a nucleus of dedicated choristers who have served their apprenticeship for many years, who will lend their experience to the new choristers coming in. And when we have someone that does that, I think it's only right and proper that we should honour them for their loyalty to the choir and their service. And we have to do that this evening, and I'm very pleased to do it, because tonight we have one of our choristers who has just completed 25 years of service. It's John Weeks in the first place. John, would you please come forward?
Oh yeah.
gentlemen, will you give a welcome back to, I'm sure, a lovely second half. If we enjoy the second half as much as we did Joanne in the first half, I'm sure we'll all be thrilled. Would you please give a very warm welcome to Joanne Thomas?
Right. Now we move towards maybe the lighter side of our record. Well, we begin our next spot with a song made famous by Matt Monro, Softly As I Leave You.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, Joan Thomas. Thank you very much, boys. Ladies and gentlemen, open mail box.